Hi everybody, this is Thor here and today I'll be talking to you guys about private condominiums. So if you guys haven't seen my first two videos about BTO and resale HDBs, do check it out. Okay, so for condominiums, they are actually entry-level private apartments. So most condominiums out there will actually have private facilities such as swimming pool, gym, clubhouse and many other exclusive facilities out there. So condominiums are more peaceful, more quiet, more exclusive, and you have lesser people and lesser neighbors staying in that condominium rather than a larger HDB estate. And not only that, condominiums have 24-hour surveillance taking care of the entire condominium as you're staying there. So the next thing I want to talk about is the investment potential of condos. So some people would like to invest in a second property, which is a condo, and they will usually rent it out to tenants to create passive income for themselves. So if you were to compare a 3-bedder condo with a 3-bedder HDB, usually the rate that tenants will pay is about $3,000 to $5,000 per month, but for a 3-bedder HDB is about $2,500 a month. So the next thing we'll talk about is the seller stamp duty known as the SSD of a condo compared to the minimum occupancy period, the MOP of a HDB. So to prevent any SSD or to pay any stamp duties, you have to own and stay in the condo for about 3 years before selling it off. But however, for HDB, you have to stay and own the HDB for about 5 years before you can officially sell it off and move on to another property. So for condos, you actually can stay there for a shorter period of time, but for HDB, you have to stay for an extra 2 years before you can sell it off and move on to the next property. So a lot of people has been telling me, "Hey Thor, only the rich can buy condos." But in my opinion, that is not 100% true, because with a combined income of 6 to 7k, you guys can actually easily buy a 1 to 2 bedder condo. But we also have to include other factors such as CPF, cash savings, as well as your eligible bank loan. So let me summarize today's video on private condos. They are entry-level private apartments with better exclusivity compared to HDBs. They are better in terms of investment potential for renting out to tenants for passive income, as well as the fact that you don't have to be rich to own a condominium. Alright, so thank you so much for watching today's video. If you have any property-related inquiries, do drop me a DM and I'll be more than happy to assist you. So I'll see you all in the next video.